Hey dudes, and welcome to another video. Today I decided to do another post commentary. I did one on a farewell video about Black Ops 3, and I had a good game there. It was 40-12. It was a fun team deathmatch. I get so hype about these new Call of Duty games, and I have so much fun when they come out, and you know, for years after. And I'm really surprised on how people can get so mad about the game. I understand that they want the game a certain way, but I think just the community changes. It's not the same as the way it started, and the way when it first came out, nobody was good at the game. So if you played the game for a couple of weeks, you ended up being really good, you know, and that's just how it was. It was like everybody was bad, and it was just a competition for who was the worst or who was the best of the worst, you know. But now the game's changed. Everybody plays Call of Duty. Everybody wants to be a competitive player. That's another thing. Competitive Call of Duty has really gotten popular now, and there's a lot of teams and stuff like that. Back when the first MW came out, I mean, that's when Optic first started and FaZe first started, and there was only a couple teams, and they didn't really make much money. They just played for fun. That was it. Now they make millions of dollars, you know, winning those tournaments and stuff like that. And it's just crazy to see the game evolve. But anyways, I'm going to talk a little bit here about Infinite Warfare. I'm playing the redesigned Terminal. In case you have never heard of Terminal, it's a map that was in MW2. And they also put it in MW3 because it was a fan favorite map. Sort of like Nuketown for Black Ops, except for the Modern Warfare series. And so they remade it into a futuristic sort of space edition for Infinite Warfare. So that's what I'm playing here. This is a team deathmatch, I believe. And then there's also another game that I'm playing after this, which is a domination, a hardcore domination. And it was a lot of fun, so we'll talk about that when I get there. But I'm rolling with this guy. I think his name's Cryptic or something like that. And his specialist that I chose, you can choose which specialist. That's kind of nice. They have more than just two options this year for the game. And I thought that was a good, fun idea. It might be a little overwhelming at times, but I chose these dual silenced SMGs. They're pretty sweet, and they rock at close range. And I don't know how this guy didn't see me. He literally went right by me. You know, he must have a really small TV he's playing on or whatever, but that's just how it is. And sometimes it's the other way around. You don't see anybody, and they just shoot you right in the back. You're like, you got to be kidding me. and sometimes I'm surprised they even get a kill. Probably shouldn't have gotten that one, and just reloading, these guys just keep coming in through the window, and I'm like, okay, that's great. But this game's a lot of fun. It's a lot like Black Ops 3, which I mentioned in my previous video on Black Ops 3. It's a lot like it. The movement system is pretty much exactly the same. There's a few differences. I would say that you don't quite boost as much when you boost. But it's pretty much the same movement, so it won't take too long to get used to. There you see, there's my score, 20-11, and I've only had this game for a couple of days, and I got a good gameplay, or a decent gameplay, and I thought I would share with some of the highlights with you guys. So now this game, I'm going into hardcore domination, and it was an accident. I actually wanted to play regular domination, but the way the playlists are set up is where there's a selection at the top. You can do L1 or R1 to decide if you want the standard game modes, the hardcore game modes, classic game modes, and stuff like that. So I must have accidentally had it on hardcore. So I had no idea I was playing hardcore until I went a little while in. I was like, okay, wait a minute. This gun is killing with like one or two bullets. I don't think that's quite right. so I eventually figured it out, but it was a lot of fun, and I didn't even notice that there wasn't no minimap. I was like, why is there no minimap? Is there a glitch or something? And then eventually I figured it out, and I actually enjoyed it. I enjoyed playing some hardcore domination. I think you guys should play it. I think it's a lot more fun than the regular domination, because it's really a pain to use a silencer, especially in a game like this, where one bullet or, you know, half a point of damage will make such a big of a difference, you know, in this game, and, you know, mobility and everything. They can sneak up behind you. So I think you guys should work on playing some hardcore, just to get used to it. And then if you guys do have the Modern Warfare, the COD 4, then you can go into that, and you already you're already used to using cover and stuff like that. Because it is a lot, it's a lot different than Black Ops 3 and Infinite Warfare. The game speed and the game mode is completely different. You can't play the same way. But I don't know if you guys ever played Modern Warfare, like the old version, the original version. But it's a lot of fun, and I'm glad they remade it. And I hope they remake these new games. I think it's great because if you ever go play the originals on like PlayStation 3, they're all covered with hackers and stuff like that. And it's really annoying because you just want to play the old game and stuff. But so it's really nice that they remastered it, and I'll be playing it for years, I'm sure. Here I'm defending A. I think I get a bloodthirsty. I think I got a triple kill there, yeah, in a UAV. But I've been having a lot of fun with this game. It can be frustrating at times, just like Black Ops 3, because sometimes you just, it's just, it doesn't seem like you're in the right lobby. You know, you're like, okay, I'm just not up to par with this competition. You know, they're just so much better at the mobility and stuff like that. And that guy just had a sweet stomp. That's another one of the specialists for the Merc, I believe. I'm playing with the Merc this round. I didn't use his specialist, though. His specialist that I had on it was like a bull run. I've never even tried it. I just said it there. I totally need to try it out, though. But I think I was talking about how hardcore is different and is probably better. You don't have to use a silencer in hardcore, and I think that's just, it's really helpful and handy. Anyways, guys, I hope you dudes enjoyed this post commentary. I definitely had fun making it, and you guys seem to enjoy the last one, so I plan on making some more. If you want to see more or a specific game mode, just let me know in the comment section below. I can't wait to play with you guys. Some of you said that you're getting either a PS4 or getting Infinite Warfare for Christmas, and I'm so excited for that. So I'll see you guys later.